The year 1776.
Goo. Goo yourself, yeah. You little dribbler.
The place? The American colonies. The battles between the colonists and King George of England had reached the boiling point. For the founding fathers, it was time to make a clean break from England.
Break time.
Yay!
Which brings us to...
The Tom Jefferson Program, starring one of America's greatest patriots, Tom Jefferson, with today's special guests, Ben Franklin, Betsy Ross, and George Washington. And now, from Independence Hall in Philadelphia, the Continental Congress Chorus.
The war is raging, we're up in arms. We Yanks are fighting to save our farms. The bells ring out, we hear alarms. The time is now, rise up in arms.
Everyone, what are you alive?
What is it? Are the Redcoats attacking?
Worse! Thomas Jefferson's gonna make a speech!
Hi, fellas. Was it something I said? Hi, folks. Tom Jefferson here at the Continental Congress. And guess what? They want me to write a Declaration of Independence, you see. A piece of paper saying we don't want to be ruled by England anymore. Of course, I'm honored, but I wonder why they asked me.
We asked Jefferson to write it because he's smart.
Because he's insightful. But most of all, because he has his own pen. Well... Mind if I borrow one? I have an insurance policy to sign. Not on your life, John Hancock. You stop that.
The fact is, Jefferson has all the pens. He's what's known as a penny pincher.
Well, whatever the reason, it's an honor just to be chosen. But now, what do I write? Oh, Ben. Ben Franklin.
Yeah, Tom.
Well, give me a hand here, would you? I have to write the Declaration of Independence. Have you got any ideas?
Oh, yeah, sure. How about this? Dear George, the King of all Britain, you make us so mad that we're spitting. So give us a break, go jump in the lake, you can't fire us because we're quitting.
Gee, I don't know.
Oh, not a poetry lover, eh? Okay, try this one. Dear England, stay on your own side of the Atlantic and we'll stay on ours.
No, not enough punch.
Oh, something punchy, eh? How about this? Straight and to the point. Dear King George III, drop dead!
Love America.
No!
I got it. Try this. Yo, King, go fly a kite. Oh, get out of here, you crazy old nut. Gee, I guess I'll have to write this thing myself.
On his way home, Jefferson stopped off to visit publisher John Dunlap.
Oh, John... John Dunlap.
Oh, no. It's Jefferson again. Quick, hide the pens.
Hello, Johnny.
Hi, Tom. What's up?
Unbelievable news. You'll never guess.
They asked you to make another speech?
No.
That's a relief.
Now cut that out. I make pretty darn good speeches, for heaven's sake.
Yeah, they're unforgettable.
Exactly.
I've never seen anyone hit with so many different vegetables.
Well, what's so bad about that? I had salad for a week.
And I sprained my throwing arm. So what can I do for you?
I'm about to write the Declaration of Independence, you see, and I'd like you to publish it.
What an honor.
For free.
What a ripoff.
Now that hurt.
Work for free. Why, the nerve of that guy. Huh? Hey, where'd my pens go? Jefferson! Jefferson, you come back here!